Hi students, today we are going to learn collective nouns. Okay, noun means it describes about the person, people, animals and other things. Likewise, and the nouns has four and five types. That is countable nouns, uncountable nouns, concrete noun, abstract noun. Okay, and now we are moving to collective nouns. Collective noun is also one part. Now we are moving to collective nouns. Collective noun means nothing. We can say about a group. Group of people or group of animal. We can say a group. If one man is standing means it is a man, right? A group of man is standing means they are people. We can say as people. And group they are standing means we can say crowd of people. Okay, like that. If one monkey is there means we can say monkey, and a group of monkeys standing there means we can say troop of monkey, right? That one we are going to learn. This is the definition. A noun which is used to refer to a group of animals. It is very important. Group of animals or group of people or group of things is called collective noun. Okay, now see here in page number 2, this is your grammar book, right? In this book we are going to learn today. Page number 2, this blue tabular column and this blue tabular column you must want to learn. Okay, learn and write. Okay, this is very important for animals here and for the man, for the people. Okay, ma? Group of people. How we can call the group of people is here, and how we can call the group of animals here. See here, for monkey we use the word troop, and fish, school of fish, flock of sheep, swarm of bees, colony of ants, herd of cattle, a pride of lions, a gaggle of geese, a flock of bats, a bask of crocodiles, a swarm of butterflies, a tribe of goats. These are for animals. Okay, from here is one paragraph is there. Look at this paragraph, read the following passages and underline the collective nouns for animals used in it. Tony and Tina went on a trip to the zoo with their grandpa. They saw a pride of lions. See here, a group of lion is called pride. So underline the word pride. Sitting quietly inside a cage under a tree, after walking for a while, they saw a bask of crocodiles. A group of crocodile are there. So we can say it bask. Underline the word bask. And sleeping on the river bank of the river. But soon they were attracted to a chattering troop of monkeys. See, troop of monkeys. So underline the word troop. Nearby, they fed bananas to the monkeys. Later they saw a gaggle of geese. Goose means one. Yes, goose, it is a bird, one. Geese means a group of birds, more than two. Yes, more than one. It is in plural form, we can say it is geese. So the geese is standing in a group means we can use the word gaggle, gaggle of geese. Okay, now and the other word, there is no collective noun. Now we are moving to the collective noun for people. See here, for players we use the word team, team of players. For soldiers, army, an army of soldiers. For people, a crowd of people. For the musicians, a band of musicians. For the singers, a choir of singers. For the friends, a circle of friends. For the thieves, a gang of thieves. For the dancer, we can use the word troop. And for the students, in the class, one student is there, means we can say student. A class full of students, a group of students are sitting means we can say class of students. Okay, now see the second exercise. Read the following passages and underline the collective nouns used for people. That is for animal, this is for people. Now see, In the first line, Swati had invented her entire circle of friends. Here, friends. Friends in a group is called circle of friends. So, underline the word circle. A band of musicians. Musicians. Musician is described as in a group, band. So, underline the word band. A choir of singers. So, underline the word choir. And a troupe of dancers. So, underline the word troupe. And in the next line, also showed their talents. A gang of thieves was also present at the party. So, which is the word here? A gang of thieves. So, gang. Underline the word gang. In the next line, but someone in the crowd of people. People in the group means we can say crowd. So, underline the word crowd. Then we let me move to the next one. This is very easy. See here, a herd. Herd, what we can say is a herd? Cattle, right? Yes. Put the number for cattle 1. A gang. A gang of thieves. Already we learned in the blue box. Okay. A school of fish. A troop of what we can come? Yes, dancers. A swarm of butterflies. Yes. What's the number? 5, 3, 1, 2, 4. Okay. Now it is like a puzzle and it is a play. So it is, I am going to give you a homework. See, a bask of crocodiles. In the first one, in this type, yes. So across type we can write here. Down means from top to bottom, up to down. You want to write here. Okay, write in the full form, collective noun full form, right? A bask of crocodiles. Next, what is the across line? Gaggle. For what animal we can say use the word gaggle? Yes, for the geese we can use the word gaggle. So how we can write? A gaggle of geese. Okay, this is your homework. From this you want to find and write. Okay, now let me move to the next page. Page number 4. Find the incorrect collective nouns in the following sentence and rewrite the sentence using the correct ones. See here, first one. A pride of cattle. We can say pride of cattle? No. How we can say? A herd of cattle. So, first one, pride. Cut down the pride and write herd of cattle. And the second thing, I saw a flock of butterflies. Flock. For the butterflies, we didn't use the word flock. For the birds only, we use the word flock. For butterflies, we use the word swam. So, write swam. And the third one, colony of birds. Colony is used for ants. Yes. What is the word? Birds? Yes, flock. So, cut down the colony and write the word flock. And the fourth one, two singers in my dash of friends. There is band given. Band of friends will not come. Band means it is musicians, right? What will come? Yes, circle of friends. Cut down the band and write circle. And the fifth one, troop of students. Troop will not come. Which will come? Class of students. So cut down the troop and write class of students. And sixth one, Seattle would like to join swarm of dancers. What will come? Swarm is for bees or butterflies. Here what will come? Troop of dancers, right? Next, seventh one, last one. The bank was robbed by a herd of thieves. Herd is used for cattle. So here what will come? Herd will strike out the herd and write gang of thieves. Okay, now let me move to the next topic. Now next topic, we are going to learn regular and irregular plural forms for the singular noun. Okay, see here, regular plural form. There is 4 rules for the regular plural form, and the first rule is end if the word end with just end means we want to add yes. Okay, See here, for example, we can take book, note, blackboard. Yes, for these words, bench, table, for these words, we can use just yes. We can just add yes. This is the first rule. And the second rule, if the word end with O, X, yes, CH, SH means we want to add ES. See here, church, it ended with CH. So this, right? CH ended with CH means we want to add ES. Yes, it is very easy, right? O, X, S, CH, SH. These letters ended means we want to add ES. And see here, consonant plus Y. Consonant plus Y means we want to destroy or strike out the Y and we want to add IES. Yes, see here, enemy. See, before the Y there is consonant. What does it mean by consonant? Consonant is nothing. A, E, I, O, U. These are vowels in the alphabets, right? Alphabets has 26 letters and A, E, I, O, U. These 5 letters are vowels. Except these 5 letters, all the letters are consonants. Okay, B, C, D, F, all the letters are consonants. So, see here, before the Y, if there is consonant, we want to strike out the Y and add IES. Okay, we want to add IES. And next rule, if the word end with F or FE, we want to strike out and we want to add BES. Okay, see here, leaf, F, ended with F. So we want to strike out and we want to add BES. 4 rules. First one, just we want to add yes. And the second one, if we ended with O, X, S, C, H, S, H means we want to add ES. And before the Y, there is consonant means we want to strike out Y and want to add IES. And F or FE ended means we want to strike out the F or FE and we want to add VES. This is the regular plural form. Okay. Simply we can say change the singular into plural form. Okay. Now take your book page number 6. Underline the singular nouns and circle the plural nouns. Singular we want to underline. Plural we want to circle. See, Vikram Aditya. A single name. So it is a singular, right? So you underline. Have you finished? Yes. Was the king? King. King means one. Yes. Kings means only lord. Yes. So king. It is a singular. So underline. And Kuntala. Kuntala is a single place, right? So underline. And in the first line, he had 3 queens. See there, S is added. So it is plural. So circle. And one day, day, day is singular, so underline. And old sage, sage, a single thing, so underline. Next one, he had brought them some presents. Yes is the, so it is plural, so circle. And asked each one to choose what she wanted. The sage just gives. Yes is the, so put circle. Was 6 mangoes. Mangoes. So circle. A sword. Sword. One thing. So underline. An old book. One book. So underline. And some pearls. Yes is there. So put a circle. For the singular you want to underline. For the plural you want to circle. Yes. These types we learn here. Yes. Now we are going to see the rules. At the end, we want to add yes. If the word end with O, X, S, CH, SH means we want to add ES. And for the consonant, before the Y, there is consonant means we want to strike out Y and we want to add IES. If the word end with F, FE means we want to strike out and add VES. This is the 4 form. Using this form, we are going to do the exercise. Page number 8, second Roman letter. Change these singular nouns into the plural forms. Loaf, F. The word ended with F. Yes, which type? This type. F. So we want to strike out the F and we want to add VES. What is the answer? Loaves. And the second word, family. The word ended with Y. Before the word there is consonant. So we want to strike out Y and we want to add IES, families. And the third one, books. Books like this. So we just add S. And fourth one, cities. City. So we want to destroy Y and add IES. And fifth one, pouch. C pouch. CH is there. So we want to add ES. Pouches. And sixth one, class. Class. So we want to add ES. Because S is here. So we want to add ES. And seventh one, prince. Prince. For that we want to add S. And next one, hero. Hero. O. End with O. So we want to add ES. Okay. Now we are moving to irregular plurals. Irregular plurals means nothing. Some nouns do not follow any of the above rules. Irregular nouns didn't follow these rules while changing to their plural forms. Such plural forms are irregular noun. See, for example, irregular plural form is different. Okay, it can be different. See here, man. Man means only one man. If a lot of man is there, means we don't say mans. Mans is not in English, right? So we want to use the word men. For and one more example, woman. Woman, we want to say women. For the plural form, we want to use men. Okay, and another one rule is there, same. In some irregular plural forms, it never change. If the singular word is deer means, and the plural also deer. If the singular is sheep means, the plural also sheep. If the singular is aircraft means, the plural also aircraft. Okay? Okay, now, see, take page number 9. This is your homework. F, it is very easy, right? Loaves. F ended with F. So we want to add, cut down the F and we want to add VES. Likewise, you want to fill these boxes. Okay, now fourth Rome letter. Underline the plural nouns in the sentences given below. We want to just underline. Oxen. Yes, in the first line, see, two oxen. Underline the word oxen. And the second one, trees. Yes, yes is there. So it is plural. Trees. And next, third one, tomatoes. ES is there. Underline the word tomatoes. And fourth one, else. VES. Yes. Next one, keys. Underline the word keys. And next one, books. In the next line, books is there. So underline the word books. And in the next line, puppies. This is the plural. So underline the word puppies. And next one, see, fifth Rome letter, correct the plural nouns in the following sentences. One is done for you. See, women's, I already told. Here, man, men, not man's. Woman, women, not woman's. Right? Okay, now second one, I must visit a dentist. Two of my tooths hurt. Tooths not. One teeth means, one tooth means we can say tooth. More means we want to use the word teeth. Okay, not tooths. Tooths is not in English. So what word we want to use? First one, cut down the tooths. Sorry, second one. First one is already there. So second one, tooths. We want to cut down the tooths and we want to write teeth. And the third one, my parents bought a lot of furnitures. Only furniture, it never changed. See, deer, beer. Furniture, furniture. So answer is furniture. Cut down the S. And the fourth one, I saw the shepherd shearing wool from four sheeps. This is also the same kind. Sheep, sheep, not change. So cancel the yes, sheep. And the fifth one, mouses. Mouses is there. In the plural form, there is mouses. Mouse, it changes to mice, not mouses. How we can change this? Not mouses, it changes to mice. And the sixth one, informations. Informations. See, informations. There is information only, not yes will come. Okay. Next one, deeds. Deed only, not deeds. Okay, students, I hope you all clear about the topic, and your homework is I give some exercise and also collective nouns for animals and collective nouns for people. You want to learn and write, and this is your homework I gave, and also the page number 9, both the puzzle type activity I give as your homework, right? Okay, thank you, students.